What's up, my awesome YouTubers? Ryan1988 or Justin back here to do a video for you guys. And today's video, I'm here to talk about one of my favorite things that I grew up with, and that is video stores. And how it's kind of sad that they are closing down. They just announced that Family Video, one of the last, or the last, big video store rental chain, is now closing. I worked at one for 6 years and I absolutely loved it. I have so many memories working there and just going to Family Video as a customer. Absolutely loved it. So I will be missing Family Video. And if I could, I would open up my own video store, kind of a local one. And, you know, that would have been awesome. So you never know in the future, but probably not. It's a dream though. Maybe I'll do it. We'll see. Anyway, I am going to miss Family Video. I'm going to miss video stores in general. If you have a local mom and pop one and it's still doing well, please go support it. You know, video stores, like many of us growing up, they were a huge memory for all of us. And, you know, family outings on Friday nights, kind of an escape just to walk in there and go through the aisles of movies, smell the popcorn, talk to employees. You know, video stores for me at least felt like a second home pretty much. And again, I worked at one for 6 years and it was such an amazing time. And I'm going to miss Family Video. And you know, it's really sad that kids today and in the future will not know what a video store was unless we talk about it. So I'm pretty sure a lot of people are sad that we are losing our last video store. And so in this video, I just want to talk about some of my favorite memories of video stores and renting movies. I pulled some titles that I remember renting, mostly on VHS. You know, back in the 90s, you know, VHS was huge. Video stores were huge. I remember renting a lot of VHS tapes. I remember going in the video stores, looking at all the different covers, really being in awe with that. And mostly going through the horror movies, which as a kid, I did not watch too many of them. But you know, growing up, you know, my mom is a big horror movie fan. And so we would watch a lot of them, and that was one of our kind of favorite things to do, was rent some movies or buy some used movies at these video stores and check out some movies. So a lot of memories, guys. And so I want to go through some of my favorite movies that I remember renting. And again, most of these were a lot of VHS tapes. So I actually have a stack of horror movies and I have a stack of non-horror movies. So we're going to go through the non-ones first. And the one I really remember the most as a kid renting was Return to Oz. This is one of my favorite childhood films. If you guys have never seen this, this is the sequel to The Wizard of Oz. So it continues the story with Dorothy returning back to Oz and realizing that everything has changed. Oz itself is kind of like, you know, destroyed, run down. You have characters like the Gnome King, Princess Mombi. You got Pumpkin Jack, TikTok, different characters in this movie. I know it's based on the books. If you've never seen Return to Oz, definitely check this one out. You know, I don't know if you can get the Blu-ray for a good price. I know I found it on eBay for $24, but I know the DVD's available and you can watch it, I believe, on Amazon. Check out Return to Oz. If it's been a while since you've seen it, I know I watched it back in October and I absolutely love that movie. The next one that I rented quite a bit with my older sister, and you know, my whole family loves this, pretty much my whole family, and that is Labyrinth. Another one of my all-time favorites. My older sister rented this quite a bit, and I was one that would rent Return to Oz quite a bit. And I can't tell you how many times we watched these movies over and over. I love Labyrinth. Everybody knows about this movie. It is definitely a classic one. Another one that kind of falls in the same line of Labyrinth and Return to Oz is a little underrated fantasy film, Legend, with Tom Cruise in one of his first movies and Tim Curry as Darkness. And I love Legend. Ridley Scott's Legend, underrated Ridley Scott movie. Not a lot of people talk about this unless you grew up with the film. For me, it's a fantastic one. And, you know, some of these movies would be considered kind of really scary films for kids. But for me, movies like Legend, Return to Oz, and Labyrinth never scared me. These were all just movies that I fell in love with as a kid. And working at a video store, you know, we had movies like Legend or Return to Oz or Labyrinth, and they would always be movies that I would recommend. Grew up with these films. This movie here, some people love it, some people don't. I might like it a little bit better than the original film. I know that's bad to say, but that is Grease 2. So I saw this for the first time on TV, but I remember renting the VHS and the first Grease, both on VHS, quite a bit at the video store. But Grease 2 for me, I just absolutely love it. I love the original film. That's one of my favorites too. But I think I like Grease 2 slightly more. I know this movie's kind of 50-50, but over time it's built this cult classic. But Grease 2, you know, rented it on VHS quite a bit. The next one, or the next two, have the same actress in it. This film here, I remember seeing on TV. I remember seeing the movie on a recorded VHS tape. And then years later, going in a video store after not seeing it for at least a couple years, and seeing the VHS tape to rent, and that is Legend of Billie Jean. This is an underrated 80s movie. Not a lot of people talk about it, but it's grown a following, and people do talk about it more and more. I do remember as a kid, though, this one was not a film that a lot of people talked about, and I grew up with it, with my mom watching it, and us watching it together, and then my sisters watching it. So if you've never seen Legend of Billie Jean, check it out, guys. Fair is fair. If you know the quote from the movie, classic film in my eyes. And then the other one has Helen Slater in it. And this is one of the first movies that made me fall in love with comic book movies. And I grew up with the film. Again, I had a VHS tape where I rented, or I had a VHS tape. I recorded VHS tape where I would watch this movie quite a bit on, and then renting it at the video store years later on VHS. And that is Supergirl with Helen Slater. Faye Dunaway's in this, you know, Peter O'Toole, you know, a lot of familiar faces. But Supergirl, classic film in my opinion. I know it's cheesy. I know it's a little bit outdated and not everybody loves this movie. But, you know, if I would never have thought that a movie like this would get a Blu-ray treatment just because I remember renting the VHS tape. And then years later, probably a decade later, you know, getting this on DVD and now a Blu-ray of it. So Supergirl, for a movie that did not do well and it was criticized, I'm glad we have a Blu-ray. And it has a lot of great bonus features too. So nothing brand new, but a lot of stuff that were on previous DVDs that were out of print or that are out of print. So now going on to some horror movies, some scary films. The one I remember renting quite a bit at a local video store, I don't know if you guys remember the name, Star Video. So let me know if you guys know what a Star Video is. But I rented this quite a bit. And again, my mom loved scary movies. She got me into scary movies. This was one of them I rented. And that is Fright Night Part 2. So, funny story with this, I rented this more than the original film, and the original film terrified me as a kid, and I just remember seeing the original cover for the first movie and not wanting to watch that movie. And I have vivid memories of seeing the first movie on TV, and it scared me. I know that's considered like a horror movie comedy, but I've always found it just like to be a straight up scary movie. Growing up, now I see a lot of the comedy in there. But, you know, it terrified me as a kid. But Fright Night Part 2, which I consider to be such an underrated movie, you know, this is a media on demand Blu-ray, so it's not a legit Blu-ray. It needs a Blu-ray, but I remember renting this quite a bit. Underrated film, underrated sequel. I hope one day that we do get Fright Night Part 2 finally on Blu-ray. Until then, this thing is perfect, and the picture quality is amazing. The next three kind of go hand in hand, directed by the same director. I remember living in Oregon, small mom and pop video store, having these films and me and a childhood friend renting these movies. And we rented Leprechaun, we rented Puppet Master, like a whole bunch of like low budget scary movies. And these three I just remember the most and loving them and still loving them now, despite some of them being cheesy, or at least one of them being cheesy. And I'll get to that in a minute. But we got Witchboard, which still one of my favorite scary movies. Absolutely love that. And along with that one, we have Witchboard 2, The Devil's Doorway, which not a lot of people talk about Witchboard 2. I think this one's up there with the first movie. Sometimes I do go back and forth. Do I like the first one or the second one better? I love them both, though. And then, not a sequel to Witchboard, and I remember the VHS being advertised on the cover that it was not a sequel, but it has the same actor who played this a sort of the same villain in Witchboard. He plays a villain in this one, and that is Witch Trap, guys. I know this movie doesn't get a lot of talk. Not a lot of people love this film, the ones who have seen it, but man, this one is so much fun, and this is just like B-movie galore. It's actually nicely directed by Kevin S. Tenney, you know, directed Night of the Demons and then Witchboard 1 and 2. I think Pinocchio's Revenge as well. But Witch Trap, this was a great one. I remember seeing this for the first time, renting it from that local mom-and-pop Oregon video store, and absolutely loving that one. So, and I still love it today, despite its cheesiness. And yeah, right there on the back, I don't know if you could see it, but it does say, you probably can't see it, it does say that it is not a sequel to Witchboard. So you couldn't really see that, but if you get your Blu-ray out, just look at the back of there, that small little box. I remember the cover itself having it advertised that it was not a sequel to Witchboard. So that was really cool. I'd like to get a one sheet of that someday. I think that would be neat. The next one, I rented this with my mom. I had seen these sequels. I had never seen the original film. I really had no idea what it was about. I just knew that I loved Jason Voorhees as a kid, watching all his movies on TV, some on VHS, but then getting or renting the original film, Friday the 13th, for the first time with my mom. And my mom was living in Illinois, or she was living in Illinois at the time, and I was visiting her. We went to the video store one night. I had never seen Friday the 13th, and she recommended it. We watched it, and all I remember is it being a great movie, and it's still a great movie today, in my opinion. But the ending making me jump, and I did not see it coming. So as I was sitting there in my seat watching this movie, I jumped out of the seat. It really got me. And if you've never seen this movie, if you don't know anything about it, which I think a lot of people do, but if you don't know anything about it, don't watch trailers, don't watch or don't hear any spoilers. Just watch the movie and maybe the ending will make you jump too. Again, that's a really well-known movie, and if you haven't seen the original film, you kind of know the story of it though. And the last two movies, so I grew up in the 90s. I loved a lot of things about the 90s. I love the 80s too, but I was born in 88. But the 90s were huge for me. And again, renting a lot of movies at the video stores. I remember seeing this movie for the first time on VHS. I think it was the weekend or the week that it came out, and we rented the movie, and I think we watched it like three times before we took it back. And that is Scream. So I did not see this in theaters. I know some buddies of mine have, but I saw it for the first time on VHS, and the movie terrified me as the first time I saw it, and it's still eerie today, but the first time I saw the movie, it terrified me, it creeped me out, and I was hooked on it. And it was me, some friends, and my older sister watching this movie in the living room like three times. And yeah, fantastic memories with Scream. And then I would see like the sequels later on. I think I rented Scream 2 and Scream 3. I think we rented on pay-per-view or on demand at the time. But Scream 1, the best memories I have in that franchise. And then the last one I have a great memory with, kind of funny. I don't know if my dad's gonna see this, but I gotta share this. Shout out to my dad, he's awesome. But I know what you did last summer. So, funny story with this. If you guys remember grocery stores, even gas stations, having kind of a like small video rental area, I remember when I Know What You Did Last Summer came out in theaters, and I remember seeing the trailer, and I was too young to see this in theaters, no one would take me. But I just remember it being advertised, and then finally it coming out on VHS. And we went to the, I think it was like a mini mart, and they had like a little area full of like rental VHS tapes, and this was displayed. This had just come out on VHS, and my dad, who's not a big horror movie fan, he definitely supports it though. He thought this by the cover was a family movie. Yeah. So I knew what it was. It kind of, it was a little odd that he thought this was a family movie, but with the fisherman on the cover. But yeah, he let me rent this. Did not know what it was. Of course I did, and kind of went with it a little bit. And when we got out to the car, I finally confessed to him that this movie was a scary movie and that it was R-rated. And he thought about taking it back, but he was like, "You know what? I'm gonna let you rent it." And so I got to see I Know What You Did Last Summer on VHS, and that's one of my favorite stories just because I do remember him thinking this was a family movie. Again, love my dad, shout out to him. But yeah, I Know What You Did Last Summer. Great memories there, guys, and so many more. I was thinking Dolly Dearest. Do you guys remember that one? I know Vinegar Syndrome just released it. Leprechaun, Puppet Master. I rented some Disney movies when I was a kid, like 5 years old or younger. Sleeping Beauty being like the biggest one for me as a kid. I can't tell you how many times we rented that movie, and my parents are probably not a fan of that movie anymore because of that. But I rented a lot of Disney movies too. Again, for me, video stores, I'm going to miss them. And I had such a pleasure working at video stores. I had, amazing times just going as a customer to the video stores, driving up with my family, seeing the posters displayed on the window, the lights around them, going in the video stores. Seeing the carpets because they were usually like odd looking carpets, and kind of smelling the popcorn. I'm gonna miss that so much. So I had to make a video talking about video stores and my memories renting, the stack of movies and plenty more that I just can't think of right now. But let me know your guys' favorite memories of video stores. Are you gonna miss them? Are you like me and you still have that nostalgia of, if you have a video store, walking into them. Unfortunately, we don't have one anymore. And I don't know if I'll ever see a video store anymore. It's kind of sad. Again, kids today and in the future will not know what a video store is unless we talk about it. So anyway, I do want to give a few shout outs. I'm going to surprise these people. I just want to, give some shout outs. Of course, there's so many people that I love and channels that I watch. I mentioned two people, and then the other channel I have not mentioned before. So definitely go subscribe to all these guys. The first one is the channel that I haven't mentioned yet, but I've been watching their videos for quite a bit, and that is Brian Goes Blue and Coco 2. I think they are fantastic. And if you guys love movies, Blu-rays, DVDs, they love all different genre of films. Check them out, guys. That is Brian Goes Blue and Coco 2. I will leave their link down below. Dead Pit Radio, Dead Pit, the guys over there, Wes, everybody over there. I love those guys and I'm glad they're back. I've mentioned them before, but they rock. So definitely check them out. I will leave, again, their channel down in the description. And the last person is my buddy Garrett, Born to Be Rad. We just did a Rad Recommendations video over on his channel. He has a really cool series called Rad Recommendations, where he brings several YouTubers, movie fans over, and nostalgia lovers for 80s and 90s, and talk about underrated movies. And we did one for one of my favorite films, one of his favorites, and that is Girls Just Want to Have Fun with Sarah Jessica Parker and Helen Hunt. So if you guys have not checked out Garrett's channel, please do so. Born to be Rad. Again, I'm going to leave his channel down in the description. Go watch his videos. He has some fantastic videos. He just started some months ago, and I think about 6 months ago, maybe. I think back in October he did his first video. So not too long ago, but the guy's amazing. I consider him a great friend. So please go check out his channel. He has amazing content over there, amazing videos, and a lot of fun stuff. And if you love, again, nostalgia, 80s, 90s stuff, like video stores being nostalgia, check out his channel, guys. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Stay tuned for this weekend. I have a video dedicated to John Carpenter coming up. It's his birthday either tomorrow or sometime this weekend. So stay tuned for that, guys. And as always, you guys are awesome. You guys rock. In with the positive, out with the negative. Go eat some Skittles. And so much love to you guys. And I'll talk to you soon.